Solve the limit as r approaches 0 in the function 1 over r multiplied by r plus 1, the quantity under a square root, minus 1 over r. Mentally put in r equals 0. In the first fraction, we have 1 over 0 multiplied by 0 plus 1, the quantity under the square root, minus the second fraction is 1 over 0. We have 1 over 0 multiplied by the square root of 0 plus 1, which is just 1. That fraction is 1 over 0 and approaches infinity. The second fraction, we have 1 over 0, and that also approaches infinity. We have the indeterminate form, infinity minus infinity. This is a tougher example. We have fractions and also a square root. The first thing we're going to do is get a common denominator so that we can combine these two fractions together. Looking at the 1 over r, we can get the same denominator as the other fraction by multiplying 1 over r, numerator and denominator, by the factor square root of r plus 1. It's important that we multiply the same factor to the numerator and denominator, because then we're multiplying by 1. We're not introducing anything new to this expression, but this does help us solve the limit. These fractions now have the same denominator. We can combine these two fractions together now. In the numerator, we have 1 minus the square root of r plus 1, and in the denominator, we have r multiplied by the square root of r plus 1. We have a difference involving a square root, which means that we're going to multiply by the conjugate. We have a minus in this case. Therefore, the conjugate will have a plus between the 1 and the square root of r plus 1. So multiply that conjugate to the numerator and the denominator, and then FOIL to expand. The first terms, easy, 1 times 1. The outer terms, 1 multiplied by the square root of r plus 1. Inside terms, negative r plus 1 under the square root, multiplied by 1. And then last terms, negative square root r plus 1 multiplied by a positive square root of r plus 1. The reason that we multiply by the conjugate is because we get a difference for these middle terms. They cancel by addition and subtraction. The first terms multiply to 1. The last terms, we have two of the same square roots multiply together, which is like the square root of r plus 1, the whole thing squared. Squaring cancels the square root. But this is the tricky part. The square root and the square actually function like brackets. Just so I myself remember this, I would just write in brackets r plus 1 and then distribute that negative sign. 1 minus r and then minus 1. If we didn't put those brackets in there and just directly went 1 minus r plus 1, we would get the wrong answer. Remember to distribute the negative sign. And now we simplify. The 1 and the minus 1 cancel. We have a negative r on top and a r on the bottom. That factor of r can also cancel top and bottom. We're only canceling the r, we're not canceling that negative sign. So that's another place to watch out for. A negative 1. It's not a plus 1. We just have those two factors multiplied together. Square root of r plus 1 multiplied by 1 plus the square root of r plus 1. We don't have any more indeterminate form. After canceling that r, there's nothing that's making the numerator or denominator equal to 0 when r approaches 0. Let's take the limit. And simplifying, we have the limit negative 1 over 2. Remember,